you're interested in anything you see in this video, it'll be all linked off and organized on my Amazon store page. I get a little bit commission from you using my links, but you can find it all at amazon.com/shop/samage, or you can just use my links down below. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we have an Amazon favorites, Amazon finds, Amazon must-haves, whatever you want to call it. If you've been following me on any of my other social media, TikTok or IG, you'll see that I have these little short 1 minute, 30 second, musical, no real description. Mainly Instagram gets actually facts about the products because TikTok has, you know, no space in their caption bar. But I have posted a few of these things, majority of these things already. So if you've seen those, this might be a little repetitive, but if you haven't, they'll all be new and all be fresh. And if you're new to my channel, feel free to hit the like button on this video because it helps a lot. And also subscribe if you want to hang out. I've done other Amazon home favorites as well. And I do a bunch of beauty content. Beauty and lifestyle girl, that's who she is. Naturally, I'm more of a long content creator because I started on YouTube. So those things are fun, really difficult to make because the shorter the video, the harder it is, to be honest. My dog is just like moving all over the couch and it's totally fine. It's totally fine. Do your thing. But I figured not everyone probably has seen those things and maybe you want to hear a little bit more. So I'm going to give a little bit of insight, a little bit of description, and a little bit of just how I use these things and why I enjoy them and think they are worth a trip to your Amazon cart. You can always save for later. We know we got a lot in our save for later, especially on Amazon. And it gets me every time. So the first few things are all from the same brand. I just like to organize my content that way. So we're gonna start with Yamazaki Homes, which is one of my favorite home brands available on Amazon, also available at Container Store. Prices are better on Amazon. Just trust me, they're better. Anytime I'm in Container Store and see something new, I absolutely pull up to Amazon and see the price difference because why would I wanna pay an extra $10, $15 if I don't have to, right? And majority of these items should be Prime too. They're totally my aesthetic. They have white and wood in all of their designs, but there are some designs with black as well, which I do incorporate black a lot in the home. So I love it. I have no problems with the quality and I think they're worth the price point though. Yeah, I do think they could have made it like $10 cheaper, you know, $5 here and there, but they're gonna get their coins, especially for me. This is the first thing. This is a slim wire basket. It's really modern. You know, a lot of things are usually mesh. I had a few of those before, or they're, you know, acrylic, and those are great options too. I have plenty of acrylic bins from Amazon, but this to me was the perfect little size to go under my wood shelves in my kitchen as our fruit container. I actually want to get another one and place it somewhere else in the kitchen and have more of like the onions and, you know, the things that can't be near the fruits, like the veggies that got to stay over there, you know. So I think it's just a really cute size and could be multi-purpose. Obviously you could put cleaning supplies, you could use it to organize your desk, your office, whatever. It's metal on the outside and then these little wood handles. The handles do not slide or rotate, which is really nice. I haven't had any issues with any of them arriving damaged. It also comes in double the width and just like a little shorter. It's a little bit more square looking than this long slim rectangle vibe, but absolutely love this. I waited till we moved to this house to buy it because I figured it would fit the aesthetic of, you know, the white curtain and the woods and all that. It's awesome. It's easy to clean too, so if any of your fruits, you know, get on it, you're good. Next up, we have the cleaning caddy, which I've absolutely featured. It has another item in it right now, but it fits a lot of sprays. There's six in it right now, but I usually have about eight in. Two of my bottles are currently moved, but here we go with seven, as you can see. It really depends, obviously, because some of them are a little beefier than others, but it's really awesome because it's a simple design that fits under my sink, so it stays there mostly, slides in real nice. It's more of a plastic bin, really easy to clean, doesn't get stained, and then there's a wood dowel. Pretty simple design, has a little stopper on it. It is really comfortable to hold, doesn't feel like it's gonna break on you at all. Minimalistic, but if you need to go clean up, a little dog accident, a little kid accident, you just grab this and you're on your way. You got everything you need, you put a few towels and you can organize it however you like. This is a little pricey to me, but I've no regrets because it keeps my sink really nice and organized and also functional. Probably their most overpriced item in my opinion, but does its job. The other item I was talking about is this bottle bag holder. Really simple design. It folds flat, so really easy to store it in this caddy or in another bin. And it has little rubber feet on it. It opens up and you can use it to hold your bags when you're like meal prepping, or maybe, you know, when you have like just like the veggie bag and you're cutting all the ends and bits that you don't need. It'll hold the bags for you, hold your Ziplocs, maybe when you're about to pipe some icing, you want to fill an icing bag. This is actually really simple, but comes in handy more times than I expected it to. I like having it around, so I use it a lot for those reasons, but it also is great if you have like hydro flask or like big blender bottles and you need to dry them. Put them on and then you can just collapse it, put it under your sink, boom, hidden away. We like that. It has little rubber tops as well, so it has a little grip to hold the bags or the bottles or whatever you use it for. Also by Yamazaki Homes. It is a little like wobbly, but it doesn't affect its usage. It just, you know, kind of has like a little shake to it because it folds. It doesn't collapse on you though, no matter what bag you're using or what bottles you use. I haven't had any issues. I've been able to like put a bag up, pour like all this soup in it or all this cheese, all this pico de gallo, no problems. You guys might actually see that first before the other socials, or at least at the same time, because that hasn't been posted yet. I thought I had 5, I actually have 4, but the last thing from Yamazaki Homes is actually downstairs, but I took clips for you because it just doesn't show well and there's no point because it shows better in its actual form. It is one of the black items that I have from them. It's a metal stand for your toilet paper. It fits perfectly in our half bath in our basement. So, you know, when guests come, you can put little sprays out, you can put your phone at the top. There's a little tray situation that's attached, and you can also store your extra toilet paper rolls in it. And they have different options for this. They have one that's like slim and white and totally conceals all of your toilet paper and just kind of flows out of the bottom. That's like more of a boxy thing. This is a little bit more open concept, but minimal and gets the job done. So you don't have to go under the sink when you're out. You have it right there within hand's reach. Handy dandy. And I think if you have a small bathroom, it works because it's narrow. And I love small space functioning items, all about it. This item I actually thought was Yamazaki Homes and I remembered it's not. They have a different version of this. This is basically, simply put, a wire organizer box. Yeah, yeah. What it does. But for those who are a little bit about the aesthetic, aka a little bit psychotic, speaking for myself, I don't like the look of a bunch of jumbled cords. It drives me nuts. My kids, you know, had virtual school for a few years and the wires were just everywhere. They tripped over them, laptops fell off tables. Like, it was just like, oh my God. Like, no matter how often you try to keep it organized, it just looks crappy. And I break out, you know, the Velcro to Velcro them together. You can get really good Velcro on Amazon too. And then, you know, life happens. So I finally bought these. This literally came in this week. I bought a set of 2. It comes with this size and then one that's a little bit smaller, which I put next to my nightstand. Perfect little size to keep, you know, my phone charger and all these like freaking cables, like my humidifier cable, my lamp cable, all that stuff concealed. So it's a simple plastic box that has open ends on each side. So you can put your surge protector into it. Ta-da, ta-da. And then you take the plug side out like this, plug it into your wall, and have everything else plugged into it, and you know, your charger cable coming out this side. Simple, affordable, worth it, really worth it. They have different versions of this. They have colored ones, they have ones without wood, they have ones that are black, ones with little patterns. I got a different one for my office that has like a little waviness to it. It's delayed in the mail, but I have this for now, and it's awesome. So if maybe you want to conceal wires at your desk, under your TV, in your room, in your office, whatever have you, it helps. It's worth it, all I'm saying. Is it a need? No, most things aren't, but it's great. We're getting into cleaning now. So the next item, I'm sure you've seen, I actually have the dog edition of it. And I'm sure I've mentioned it, but this is the Chomp Chomp. I always say Chomp Chomp, but it's Chomp Chomp. And I have to stop myself because of Mario. But anyway, I'm taking this chain chomp too. A whole mess. This is awesome. It's basically a lint roller. I'm sure you've seen different ones with this like red velvety velour feeling to it, which helps grab pet hair, human hair, lint, dust, all that stuff that gets stuck on our furniture or our clothes. You can use it on your clothes, but I mainly use this one for my furniture. I have more of like a wand style one for my clothes from the OXO brand, but this is honestly amazing. Some people use it for the carpet, but I think if you need a larger space done, I would get like the rubber broom instead if you want to really see like how much pet hair, human hair is stuck after you're vacuuming. This to me is great to use on furniture because my couch tends to, you know, grab lint from clothing, little fuzz balls, and this gets it right off. You just back and forth, it flicks it, and then you'll see, this isn't all from right now, obviously, but this was from my couch. Big deal, a lot of dust. And on white or beige color furniture, when the dust collects, it makes it look dingy. So once or twice a week, I'll just real quick. And it takes no real force. It does it for you. Simple, but really useful. I have a very furry dog, but mainly I have very sheddy kids. They shed, not, no, that sounded almost bad, but if you were listening closely, they just shed a lot. They have a lot of hair. It's long, it's black because I have natural black hair, and it just falls out everywhere. I'm sure I'm shedding too. I'm just shedding in smaller pieces. And I'm like, what is it? Why is it? How does it? What? You know, but if you are in the same situation, this is only a few dollars and it works. Like, it won't really break on you. It's gonna last forever. I say you could, you know, hang this up in high traffic areas and have it in reach. Cleaning sprays that I just need in my life. This is my second bottle of the Pink Stuff spray. I'm sure you heard me talk about the Pink Stuff paste. If you've watched my channel, I had it in a TikTok Made Me Buy It video and I explained how the paste isn't really my favorite. It helps a lot of people with rust or crayon on the walls. Honestly, it does help in times, but it dries out really fast for me, so that gets a little annoying. But when I need to really scrub something off of pots or metal or, yeah, like some sort of color off of a surface, it's great because it has that like grainy, sandy feel to it in a like clay mixture, and it helps. It has grit. This obviously is water-based, so it is not gritty, but it is the Pink Stuff Miracle Multi-Purpose Cleaner. This is my second bottle. I'm down to about where this label starts, and I wipe my countertops daily with it. I wipe everything with it. I wipe the floor with it. It just works. It just works. Anything that doesn't need to be Windex, basically. Anything that isn't glass, I use this. And sometimes even on things with glass. And it's great. It works better than a lot of the other store-bought stuff. It smells good. It smells clean. It smells fresh. I think it's a little lemony, but the only downside is typically it's sold in packs of three. So initially, me, my sister, and my mom split a pack of three. I ran out of mine, got a whole pack of three for myself. Got it all stockpiled in the basement. This stuff's good. We've driven past people in DC and we've seen people detailing the inside of their car using the spray. This just does it. Get your sticky cup holders done, all the above. So highly recommend this. The three pack's pretty affordable too. And if you have someone to split it with, even better. It's like that Costco situation where you have to buy something and then find someone to split it with you. And now our Folex. So this is the Instant Carpet Spot Remover. In full transparency, I've heard this is cheaper at Home Depot. So if you can find this at your Home Depot, absolutely grab it there. I don't know the price difference, but I think people are saying it was closer to like $6 there. I think I got this closer to 10-ish on Amazon, 10, 11. When I bought it, I am almost out, so I definitely need another one. It's literally down to here. This is the solution to food stains, to any stains. This is what I grabbed for first for stains. This and hydrogen peroxide, I think you can get 99% of the stains out of your life, probably, just with those two things in your house. If something stains one of the light pieces of furniture, I use this. This is awesome. The only thing I don't use this for is any blood stains. Like, doesn't really get all of that out. Peroxide works a lot better. But anything else? It says pet accidents, coffee, grease, ink, red wine, food, cosmetics, dirt, grime, most old stains. It does work on old stains, and this is something great that you could spray on before you're gonna, like, what is it called? Extract it with a little green machine or whatever you have. You don't have to use it with that either. A lot of people say the proper way to use this is to spray a little on, a little scrub with your finger, and then wipe it off with a microfiber. I either do that. I don't usually let it sit as long because it kind of takes the stain out quickly, but I'll take it on a microfiber cloth and just do, stain be gone. Instant stain be gone. A little bit goes a long way. I'd be going with it because it helps so much. The hype is real on this. It really is. Home Depot or Amazon, I don't really care where you get it. I just think if you have stains and you want to try something new, here it is. I think we're covering a lot, right? We're covering a lot. Next thing is new. It's actually sitting right here. I want to talk about some vases, a little home decor. I think I'll do a little Instagram home decor one too. This is my newest vase. My Mother's Day bouquet that the kids picked out from Trader Joe's. This is the brown it comes in. Honestly, it looks a little lighter with water in it, but without anything in it, it actually looks like an amberish brown. It comes in dark gray and also like a darker sagey green, almost getting into emerald territory. Beautiful options, definitely worth the cost, because a lot of freaking vases at Target can't have water on the inside of them, you know, because they're dry flowers only. And now that I am a gardener, as me and my sister say, which is a gardener mixed with an engineer, honestly, it's just a weird word I came up with because I'd just be finessing things and probably not doing it correctly. I'm into plants now, so now I like having bouquets around the house. I'll be cutting little things from my garden. Obviously, this is store-bought, but that's what I needed a vase for. I needed a big vase for bouquets or any sort of arrangements. Gorgeous piece, even without flowers in it. When you have something a little little smaller, I recently bought a 3-pack of these little bud vases. They're very cute. So this is the largest. It has a medium and it also has a small, as you can see here. And it's perfect for any of your garden clippings or something you're trying to grow, propagate, like adorable, modern. It has a little lip at the top so the water isn't as exposed. It's just a normal vase, which is nice. I honestly made a mistake in buying these thinking that this was gonna be a similar size to the vase I just showed you. It is similar-ish in height, but that's about it. Hello, leaf. Get her later. The width wasn't what I was imagining correctly. So this is not for bouquets or arrangements because of the opening right here, which is definitely less than 2 inches. Little carnations in it from a different bouquet I had. And then different sizes for whatever needs. Really affordable though. It's like a 3-pack for, I wanna say it was like 20. Double check. $29.99, but for 3. High quality glass, really nice. I'm cool with it because one vase at Target costs like $20. It's true, and you know it. The next product has a little bit of a follow-up because I have mentioned it in one of my Amazon home favorites before. This is my milk frother. It comes with a little base stand, really easy to store. I keep it in a drawer, take it out as needed. It has a clear lid usually. It's over there and a little frother inside the whisk situation. It comes with a replacement one too. It's a little pricier than most frothers. Like the handheld ones are like a few bucks, right? Like 10 bucks. This one is a little bit more and I swear it was cheaper when I bought it and they raised the price, which I think when I checked the price history, they did, but it's awesome. Obviously a whisk is better for those who don't want another appliance, but for those who drink a lot of coffee, got a little coffee station, got a little drink station of any sort, this is great because you can set it and come back to it compared to, you know, needing the froth, I guess. It just sounds hecka lazy, but the cool part is if you like cold foam and or hot froth, hot milk, I originally was using this for my hot matcha lattes and or ice, you know, but it starts hot no matter what. So this was something that I used because it has 3 different heat settings and it has little symbols like small cup, medium cup, big cup. As far as my like steamed froth milk, I would use it on one of those settings. But then I remember saying like, I don't know who would ever use like the cold setting or something around those lines. I get it now because I make my own vanilla sweet cold foam at home. I saw a little YouTube video, put a little heavy whipped cream, a little maple syrup, a little vanilla extract, and double click the blue. Let it go 2 rounds on the blue. It's amazing. It's great. It's a thick and it's, to me, worth it. Maybe not for everybody, but I understand all the usages now. Thought she deserved an honorable mention because she's so easy to clean. She's been working beautifully. I've had her for almost 2 years now and I like it. I like it. So final 3 for today, just for today. I used to have this dish rack from Yamazaki Ho. One of the products that I'm just like eh about because it's one of those things that you're supposed to put your dishes or your cups on it and the water drains back into the sink. Sounds good. Kind of works that way. Not really that much of an issue. Always kind of look kind of grimy. The water splotch dried, a little funny, but also it's small. Like really small. So only useful for a bowl or two in a cup, maybe. I need more out of that while also saving space. Kind of counterproductive. So when I saw the roll up dish rack, I was sold because I could put it across half my sink, a third of my sink, none of my sink, and still use it. It is wrapped in silicone basically, and it has like metal rods that keep it really strong, and it's weighted on the ends. So when you roll it out in front of your sink, it holds really well. You can put your pots, your pans. I've put many pots and pans and glass on top. It does not shake unless you hit it, obviously, but it has never collapsed on me. It hasn't given me any issues. It's easy to clean. You just wipe it down, dry it off. It's also like that black silicone, so if you don't dry it from time to time, then you'll have little water spots, but it's so minimal in comparison to how much surface area the previous dish rack had. So I really like it. It's simple. A lot of different sellers on Amazon. I will obviously have the one that I purchased from linked off. I think it's great for those who want to maybe put that away under the sink when they're not using it and or keep it out on half their sink at all times or just put it on their counter. No matter what, it's gonna work. Now this one depends on, you know, the person, but maybe you're looking for something like this. And I was looking at it during our home renovation, which I did document for you guys if you want to see it. It has its own separate video. That was last fall. I can't believe that was in November and we're already in May. I've really been enjoying the renovation and my favorite drawer is probably this drawer because of this insert. It is a pegboard. I mean, it is what it's called, which you can definitely DIY. Feel free to do so. I just bought it because that's what I wanted to do. But it's basically a piece of wood with holes in it. You could pre-drill if you really wanted to, but they come drilled if you buy it. And it comes with these little wood peg pieces with little metal ends. goes in, hold your bowls. I'm sure you've seen them on TV or something like that, or maybe you have some in your home already. But this, to me, was worth it. I believe it was close to 80 bucks, and I was cool with it. Obviously, if you do it yourself, you DIY, you handy dandy, you'll save a lot of money. But it came with plenty of the wood pegs. I have literally maybe 8 downstairs, so if I did ever want to make another board, I have plenty of those. And it's sturdy. It comes in what I want to say is closer to maybe like 38 inches or more, but I have 30-inch cabinets, so you just cut it down with a saw. You can go to Home Depot, get it cut, or whatever. Ask a neighbor, cut it down to the correct size, sits right into your drawer. You don't have to screw into anything, and just put the pegs on and put your bowls in. It's amazing. So you could get a lot of use out of drawers. You could cut it into many drawers. You want to split that piece, put it into a bunch of small. It's handy. So your stuff doesn't shake when you push the drawer in, and it allows you to store different items without worrying about, you know, cracking or anything like that. I have literally all of our bowls and plates in this drawer, and even like small little sauce plates, and it's wonderful. It made it so functional in one drawer, which in turn saves a lot of space. If you're looking for something like that, I'll have it on my store page, because that and our spice insert in our little pullout drawer, those things really make a big difference. And a lot of people probably don't know that they're available on Amazon. RevaShelf honestly makes everything. It's like the company that makes every insert in cabinets ever. So if you want to tackle this, this is really easy. You just have to cut it. That's it. That's not a big project compared to, you know, installing the spice rack. But that's not even a big project either. So both of those are on there. They're on there. Cheers to the last product for today. This was in my recent Amazon video, which was Amazon travel favorites. Just a few things. I think there's like 4 things that I really like. This is something that you can use at home or traveling, obviously. These are my headphones that I bought in November during the home reno. I adore these. Of course, they're aesthetic. They're cute. They're beige. They're wireless. But aside from the color, which of course is what naturally caught my eye, I did a lot of research on noise canceling headphones because I cannot stand being overloaded with loud noise. If I can't stand, I literally mean like I can't stand it. Like I shut down, I can't really think, I can't really move, I can't deal with sensory overload. And that's something that has started in my mid-20s, now almost 30s. That wasn't a thing before, but if like, you know, like there's renovation noise or, you know, yard crews, if it's too much and I can't focus, I have these bad boys. They're very comfortable. I'm a girl who started YouTube with some Beats by Dre headphones, regretted asking for it for Christmas. Them joints hurt. They just hurt my ears, they hurt my head. I don't like wearing headbands, I have a tender head. These don't hurt. They're padded very well. Really nice thick foam padding on the ears and here. None of the like plastic exposed ever touches my head and ever leaves it sore. Very comfortable, I can wear it with earrings, doesn't snag on any of them. These are the Jabra 85Hs. They also make like wireless buds and stuff. But this came up on a lot of tech blogs about being the most affordable option. That's great, like best affordable option for noise canceling wireless headphones. That's what I need. So you can do yard work in them. I garden with these all the time. It's a little scary because they cancel so much noise that my dog like pops up next to me and I'm like ah, and I like throw things, but it's helpful. So when I have these on and I'm talking right now, I would say even my own sound is muffled down by 50%. And I mean, my mouth is right next to my ears. That's the closest thing. But like my kids can be talking, I can't hear them. I barely can hear them. I maybe can hear a little like, what was that? But they're great. They're great. Sound quality is really good. They're pretty durable too, because I'd be like, the one thing that's a little annoying is that you have to put them flat like this because they do, you know, they have the swivel. This is off. Anything that's not flat is on. So if one's tilted, it's on. That ear is on. You can connect up to 3 devices. There's buttons on the side. The battery life is crazy. I believe in 15 minutes, it charges like 5 hours worth of battery time. And I think, God, how many hours? Let's see. 36-hour battery life. Mm-hmm. It comes with a case and a wire. They're worth the cost. They're not that expensive either because they're pretty affordable. Has little ports if you want to connect wires, if you're flying or something like that. Has a little mic button. You can adjust the volume on it. Folds really nicely and it's cute. Comes in black, navy, this beige, and I think one more, which is slipping my mind right now, but I really, really like them. I don't talk about headphones almost ever on this channel. I really, really like them, and I've just been using AirPods prior to that. So if you're looking for headphones for whatever reason, feel free to use those. I suggest you get those. They also make a half size version of it, which my sister bought for my niece who is autistic and also like really needs good headphones, but they're like half the size, half accidentally. Way more simple, like there's no buttons on the side, it's just the ears, and like looks more for a kid or a smaller adult. But anywho, those are your options. My niece destroys headphones in some rages sometimes, so they've been lasting well too. Okay, I think that's it for today. I think I've earned Amazon enough money and attention and a free promo. About right. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you leave a thumbs up if you made it to this point in the video. Leave a little shopping cart emoji and let me know down below what you plan on getting, if anything at all, from this video. And if you are not getting anything, let me know what one of your Amazon recommendations are, because I would love to hear it. My bank account wouldn't, but I would. My stomach is growling, so it's time for me to go. If you would like to check out my recent uploads, they'll be on the screen right now. I'll also link off my last Amazon favorites as well as my subscribe button. For those who have not joined our fam yet, you can feel free to hit this button. She's free 99, and we'd love to have you stick around for a bit, enjoy more of my content. I'm always posting, I want to say like 5-6 videos a month. So if you're enjoying, I appreciate you. If you made it to this point, I appreciate you. Thank you for your time, and I will see you guys in a later video.